Cześć, dzień dobry. Zapraszam na kolejną lekcję polskiego. Mam na imię Kasia, a to jest kanał Polish with Blondes. In today's lesson, we're going to learn feminine nouns and practice those nouns which don't have this typical ending that you already know, which is letter A. So typically, Polish feminine nouns end with A. Kobieta, kawa, herbata, mapa, lampa. But there is also a group that doesn't. And that's what we are going to focus on today. Zaczynajmy. The first one I want to mention is pani. Pani. Ta pani. A feminine noun. And that's so common. That's why it's the first one I wanted to mention. And you use this a lot because if you don't know someone in Poland, you don't want to use the you singular person. Instead, you want to use the third person using the word pani for women and pan for guys. For example, przepraszam, czy wie pani, gdzie jest bank? Przepraszam, czy wie pani, jak dojść do centrum? And then another one will be a group of nouns that at the end have letter C, such as pomoc, moc, noc. So knowing that noc is a feminine noun, then when you say this night, ta noc, good night, dobranoc, życzę ci dobrej nocy. Pomoc, potrzebuję pomocy. Poproszę o pomoc. Notice that in the accusative, those nouns ending with C, but also some other consonants, which I will show you later, don't take the letter L. So this change in the accusative case from A, from A to L, does not happen in this case. Miała pani spokojną noc? Then those nouns finishing with ść. They often are feminine. Not always, though. Let me now show you the feminine ones first. Wiadomość. Dostałam dobrą wiadomość. So again, you can see in the accusative case, the adjective changes, but not the noun. But when you want to say this news, ta wiadomość. So if you use the masculine word for this, ten, together with the word wiadomość, it will sound awkward. Ta wiadomość is the correct version. Another one. Miłość. Radość. Złość. These words expressing emotions ending with sici are all feminine. So you could say piękna miłość. Wielka radość. Or also the noun nienawiść. Nienawiść. So, one more time, miłość, radość on the positive side, złość, nienawiść on the negative one. Having said that, I can't say that all the nouns ending with c or si, ci are feminine nouns, because there are those that are not. For example, koc, ten koc, gość, ten gość. Also talking about how those nouns change in different cases, we've said that in the accusative, they don't take the ending L, typical for other feminine nouns ending with a letter A. But in the instrumental case, they will take a typical feminine ending, which is O. For example, chcę się podzielić tą wiadomością. Powiedział to ze złością. Przychodzę z pomocą. And in the genitive case, also, they will take typical endings for feminine nouns, so letter I or Y, such as potrzebuję pomocy, nie mam wiadomości, nie mam od niej wiadomości, o dużo miłości, dużo radości. You could use it for wishes. Życzę ci dużo radości w życiu. Życzę ci dużo radości w życiu. Another one that's quite common is dłoń. Dłoń. Ta dłoń. moja dłoń. And one more, rzecz. Rzecz is a thing. It has consonant at the end. Nevertheless, it's a family noun. So this thing, ta rzecz. This useful thing, ta potrzebna rzecz. O, ta przydatna rzecz. This is my thing. To jest moja rzecz. To jest moja rzecz. A few more examples. Podróż. Podróż. Jak minęła twoja podróż? Jak minęła twoja podróż? Miałeś dobrą podróż? Miałaś dobrą podróż? Twarz. Twarz. Moja twarz. Also kradzież. Kradzież. Odzież. Odzież. Zazdrość. Zazdrość. Cierpliwość. Cierpliwość. Tutaj potrzebna jest cierpliwość. Część. Część. Ta część filmu jest bardzo ciekawa. Ta część filmu jest bardzo ciekawa. You might have noticed that most of these nouns end with some Polish characters. So it's ci, ni, ż, spelled either with z with a dot or rz. So these nouns can be feminine. I'm not saying they always are. And basically, in any language, it's hard to come up with a rule that will 100% work in every case. But these rules help you to learn and to memorize things quicker. At least, I hope so. On to some practice now. I'm going to ask you to use an adjective together with a noun that appears on screen. So first one is wiadomość, and you will now want to say good news, good message. How would you say that? Dobra wiadomość. Dobra wiadomość. Next one is pomoc. Pomoc. And let's use it together with the word needed. Potrzebna pomoc. Potrzebna pomoc. And let's try to use it in the accusative. Saying I appreciate your help. Doceniam your help. Twoją pomoc. Doceniam twoją pomoc. But I come with help. Przychodzę z pomocą. Przychodzę z pomocą. Twarz. Let's say a smiling face. Uśmiechnięta twarz. Uśmiechnięta twarz. Another one we practiced today was miłość. How do you say great love? Wielka miłość. Wielka miłość. Next one. Rzecz. Let's say an important thing. Ważna rzecz. Ważna rzecz. Let's use pani, a nice lady. Miła pani. Miła pani. At the end of this video, you'll find the whole list of words, of feminine words, with untypical ending that I've used today. Also, in the description below, you'll find a PDF with notes from today's lesson. Na dzisiaj to wszystko. Miłego dnia. Do zobaczenia.